is our seventh circuit dialogue for the year, collaborating with our startup, we can create our moving edition. That Lean is a movement that was started by Sheryl Sandberg. The purpose of Lean is really just to, you know, tell everyone of the world, just pursue whether you're guy or female, do not be constrained by the status quo. Pursue what you dream, believe in yourself. I have a dream to, in my career, I want to be somewhere, I want to contribute something to society. Basically, what we hope to achieve is to create a platform that enable, that even empower and educate people in Malaysia to pursue what you want in life. And at the same time, what we hope to achieve is to create a network that helps to be an inspiration and to be there to support each other.
Ladies and gentlemen, contrary to what most of you may think, we live in an era of declining entrepreneurship. Not rising, but declining entrepreneurship. The good news, however, is that Southeast Asia is actually entering a startup Shangri-La era.
The other part of success, obviously, is making sure that you have people to celebrate it with. Because if you're able to achieve that and you're alone doing it, you feel half empty. And for me, it's making sure that you always keep the people close to you who are your cheerleaders and also believe in you and, you know, just your loved one. Failure is inevitable, but you don't call it failure. I wouldn't call it failure. But obviously, it's low points, right? It's points where you're like, really, is it worth it? And that's why I feel it's so important to find something that you're very, very passionate about and love, because you're gonna hit those really, really low points, even early on. And unless you love what you do, you're not gonna have the strength to carry on.
I do things organically. Like, I don't overthink it, but I have an end goal. And that's a good thing, it's not a bad thing. It's just how you look at me scared, or how you look at me doubtful, right? So I think the best advice is just to embrace it, is to like acknowledge it. So acknowledge that you have doubts and then kind of ask yourself the why.
I think my philosophy about business is that it should fulfill a need. Whether it's your need or someone else's need, it doesn't really matter. And it's not necessarily in the form of you have to start a tech business or an online business. It can come in so many ways. I think you pick the vehicle that fits your idea the best, whatever that idea is. As long as you feel you are here serving your purpose, I think that's success.
Success is where I'm happy for what I'm doing, where actually at age of 30, I have achieved so-called financial freedom. Do not need to worry for money, but doing things what we love to do and not do things that we need to do. We should not define a failure in our life, but we should define it as our experience. So what is not a failure, but the experience that we should learn from it and move on and achieve better.
To just go through like your hypothesis, do you have any tips or ideas?